How does SALSA Digital MLPA work? The SALSA Digital MLPA method consists of the following steps: denaturation, hybridization, ligation, amplification by PCR, sequencing on an Illumina-based platform, and data analysis using Cofalizer Digital MLPA. Denaturation. For the probes to bind to their targets, the sample DNA must be denatured. In a tube, 4 microliters of sample DNA is mixed with 2 microliters of SALSA barcode solution. The barcode oligo must be unique for each sample in an experiment. The barcode oligo consists of a unique 10-nucleotide barcode for sample identification after sequencing. The RD1 sequencing primer is used for regeneration, and the P5 PCR primer binding site is used for probe amplification. This tube is placed in the thermocycler and heated for 10 minutes at 98 degrees Celsius, causing the DNA strands to separate. Hybridization. During hybridization, probes bind to their respective targets. Hybridization master mix is added. This master mix contains SALSA Digital MLPA probe mix and SALSA MLPA buffer. A digital MLPA probe mix can contain around 1,000 different digital MLPA probes, each targeting a specific DNA sequence. Each digital MLPA probe consists of 2 pieces of single-stranded DNA, a left and a right probe oligonucleotide. The 2 probe oligos contain hybridization sequences that bind to immediately adjacent target sequences on the sample DNA. Each probe's hybridization sequence is unique. The right probe oligo contains a digital MLPA-specific read identifier. This read identifier is used to identify digital MLPA reads in a FASTQ file. The barcode oligo also attaches to the right probe oligo. The P5 and P7 primer binding sites are used during the PCR step for probe amplification. The probes hybridize to the sample DNA during the overnight incubation. Ligation. Ligation on day 2 ensures that only perfectly hybridized oligos will be amplified. Ligase master mix is added. This master mix contains water, SALSA ligase buffer A, SALSA ligase buffer C, and SALSA ligase 65 enzyme. Ligase 65 binds to the left and right probe oligos that have hybridized to directly adjacent sequences. The ligase catalyzes the creation of a covalent bond between the 2 oligos. The ligation step is carried out at 48 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes and ends with heating the mixture to 98 degrees Celsius for 5 minutes to inactivate the ligase 65 enzyme. A subsequent incubation step at 65 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes is used to reduce background. The ligase 65 enzyme is very specific. If there is a single nucleotide mismatch between the probe oligo and its target sequence at the ligation site, the enzyme will not be able to ligate the 2 probe oligos. The specificity of the ligase 65 enzyme is why digital MLPA can be used to distinguish a gene from a highly similar pseudogene, or to detect a specific point mutation. Amplification by PCR. Amplification of the ligated probes is done by PCR. Polymerase master mix is added. This master mix contains water, the SALSA polymerase, and the SALSA PCR primer mix P5-P7. The PCR primer mix contains DNTPs as well as the forward and reverse P5-P7 PCR primers. Once ligated, all digital MLPA probes are exponentially amplified using the single PCR primer pair. The PCR reaction consists of the following steps: denaturation, primer annealing, and primer elongation. These steps are repeated 45 times. Sequencing. Digital MLPA amplicons are sequenced using an Illumina-based sequencing platform. No post-PCR cleanup or library concentration measurement is necessary for digital MLPA. Preparation of the digital MLPA library for sequencing depends on the Illumina instrument you will be using. All digital MLPA library preparations begin with the mixing of 5 microliters of each PCR reaction into a single tube. This is your digital MLPA library. It is important to remember that each reaction in the library must have a unique barcode. The library is diluted with ultra-pure water. Depending on the platform, you may also need to denature the library using NaOH and dilute it further using cold Illumina HT1 buffer. The prepared digital MLPA library is added to the appropriate well on the sequencing reagent tray. The sequencing reagent tray is then loaded in the Illumina sequencer and the run is immediately started. We recommend 110 nucleotide single end reads for digital MLPA sequencing. At the end of the run, a FASTQ file is generated. Data analysis using Cofalizer digital MLPA. The FASTQ file generated by the Illumina sequencer is directly used by Cofalizer digital MLPA for analysis. Cofalizer digital MLPA is software developed by MRC Holland for digital MLPA data analysis. Cofalizer digital MLPA extracts the digital MLPA reads from the FASTQ file, aligns the reads to the probes in the probe mix, and assigns them to a specific sample using the unique barcode oligo. Cofalizer digital MLPA then generates read counts for each probe and uses a series of normalization steps to compute the interratios, or final probe ratios, of the digital MLPA probes. Within an experiment, probe values of a test sample are compared to those of reference samples for copy number determination. Probe values are also used to perform a large number of quality checks to ensure that data quality is not compromised. Depending on the application, digital MLPA results are sorted by either gene or genomic location for ease of result interpretation. Cofalizer digital MLPA creates PDF reports that visualize the probe ratios of each sample and highlight the identified aberrant regions. Let's take a look at what these probe ratios tell you about the tested sample. As most human genes are diploid, the following examples are based on a gene for which the normal copy number is 2. If both copies of a diploid gene are present in the test sample, you will obtain a digital MLPA probe ratio of 1. In this case, each probe has detected the same number of gene copies in both the test sample and the reference samples. In the test sample shown, digital MLPA has detected no aberrations. Now we will give an example of what copy number aberrations look like in a digital MLPA ratio chart. A probe ratio of 0.5 in a test sample indicates that based on read counts, only one gene copy has been found, compared to 2 copies in the reference samples. Digital MLPA has detected a heterozygous deletion. On the other hand, a probe ratio of 1.5 in a test sample indicates that this sample has 3 copies of the targeted gene, compared to 2 copies in the reference samples. Digital MLPA has detected a heterozygous duplication. Now to summarize some key features that make digital MLPA the technique of choice for the simultaneous copy number determination of a large number of targets. Digital MLPA is highly specific. It requires 2 probe oligos to bind perfectly to their hybridizing sequences for them to be successfully ligated and amplified. A mismatch of just 1 nucleotide at the ligation site will prevent ligation. This also makes it ideal for CNV analysis of complex genomic regions. There is no amplification bias in digital MLPA. In digital MLPA, the probe is amplified, not the sample DNA, enabling the use of a universal primer pair. The lack of amplification bias also ensures that there is low probe read depth variability, thereby reducing the sequencing coverage needed for reliable data analysis. Digital MLPA uses only 20 nanograms of DNA and is highly multiplexable. You can include up to 384 digital MLPA reactions in one sequencing run, and these can be further combined with other NGS sequencing libraries. Lastly, digital MLPA data is analyzed by our free software, Cofalizer Digital MLPA. Digital MLPA aims to streamline CNV detection by offering broad gene coverage for a large number of genes in one assay, reducing both sample costs and turnaround time. Interested in learning more about how digital MLPA can simplify CNV detection in your lab? Visit mrcholland.com/technology/digitalMLPA.